Thank you, John, and thank you to all of you for coming out for this important announcement today. This campaign is about defending our constitutional democracy. And it's also a test. It's a test of the patriotism of all Americans. It's a test of the patriotism of Congress. Will we rise to this challenge, one of the greatest challenges our constitutional democracy has ever faced? We are confronted with a president who does not understand and does not respect our Constitution, who does not understand and respect our American traditions, our American values. This is a president who does not respect freedom of religion, who believes instead that he can dictate which religious groups will be protected and which religious groups will be excluded. A president who does not understand or respect freedom of speech and the press, but believes instead that he can dictate what the press and the public in general can say about him, about his administration, about his family, and about the affairs of the day. This is a president who does not believe and respect the free enterprise system, but instead believes that he can dictate to businesses that they shall support, promote, and buy the products and services made and sold by him and his family for profit. We're dealing with a president who does not respect the fundamental principle that no public official, especially the President of the United States, may allow his personal financial interest to interfere with the public interest that he is sworn to uphold. This is a president who believes that the presidency is simply an extension of his family business, there to facilitate more profits for him and his family. At bottom, this is a president who does not accept and appears to be incapable of accepting that he answers to the American people and not the other way around. We can again have a constitutional democracy or we can have a dictatorship, but we can't have both. These almost 900,000 signatures that we've brought to Washington, D.C. today represent millions and millions and millions more Americans who are answering that question and demanding a constitutional democracy. It's time for Congress to do the same thing. It's time for Congress to do their job and begin impeachment proceedings.